we are going to write a balance equation for the given redox reaction. The question is asking for basic condition, and if you're looking to balance the equation in acidic condition, do stick around because these four simple steps that we're going to use will give us the balance equation in both acidic and basic condition. So let's get started. For the first step, we need to write out the oxidation and reduction half equation. And to do that, we'll have to first figure out the oxidation number for each of the atom. If you need a refresher, I'll link a video here. From the oxidation number, it looks like nitrogen undergoes oxidation because the oxidation number increased from +1 to +3, whereas Cl undergoes reduction because its oxidation number decreased from +1 to -1. Now we can write out our half equations. For oxidation, it's N2O going to NO2-, whereas for reduction, it's ClO- going to Cl-. Next, we need to balance the atoms. It's very important that we follow the sequence, otherwise we're going to have a hard time balancing the equations. So we start with our oxidation equation. We need to balance all atoms except oxygen and hydrogen. So that means we need to balance the nitrogen here. So on the left-hand side, we have two nitrogen, and on the right-hand side, we have one nitrogen. So that means we're going to have to put a 2 in front of NO2-. Moving on, we're going to balance oxygen using H2O. On the left-hand side, we have 1O. On the right-hand side, we have 4O. So that means we're going to have to add 3 H2O on the left-hand side. Now we move on to balancing H using H+. Since we added 3 H2O, that means we have 6 hydrogen on the left. And since we don't have any hydrogen on the right, we'll add 6 H+ on the right-hand side to balance the H. We're now done with the oxidation. Let's move on to the reduction equation. We need to do the same thing here. We start with Cl. Both sides have the same number of Cl, so that means it's already balanced. So we move on to oxygen. On the left-hand side, we have 1O. On the right-hand side, we don't have any O. So we are going to add 1 H2O on the right-hand side. And because we add 1 H2O on the right-hand side, now we have 2 H on the right-hand side, but no H on the left-hand side. So we balance that by adding 2 H+ on the left-hand side. With that, we're done with step 2. Moving on to step 3, we need to balance the charge by adding electrons. From the oxidation equation that we have balanced, the total charge on the left-hand side is 0 because N2O and H2O, they are both neutral compounds which has no charge. So no charge plus no charge equals 0. On the right-hand side, we have 2 times -1 from NO2-, and we have 6 H+, so that gives us a total charge of +4. In order to balance the charge for our oxidation equation, we're going to have to add 4 electrons on the right-hand side. That way, the total charge will become 0 and both sides have the same charge. Let's do the same for the reduction equation. Left-hand side, we have a total charge of +1, and right-hand side, we have a total charge of -1. So that means we're going to have to add 2 electrons, and that will give us -1 on both sides. Now that we've balanced the charge on both sides, we need to make sure that the number of electrons in both equations are the same, meaning equalize. For oxidation, we have 4 electrons, whereas for reduction, we have 2 electrons. So let's multiply the entire reduction equation with 2, and that will give us the same number of 4 electrons. Here's a tip. When adding electron, for oxidation, make sure that it's added on the right-hand side, and for reduction, make sure it's added on the left-hand side. If you find the electrons on the wrong side of the equation, that means something went wrong somewhere, so go back and check the work. Now that we've balanced the atoms and charges, let's add up both equations to give us the balance equation in acidic condition. From oxidation, we have N2O and 3H2O on the left, plus the 2 ClO- and 4 H+ and 4 electron from the reduction equation. Don't forget that we multiplied 2 for the entire equation. And for the right-hand side, we have 2 NO2-, 6 H+, and 4 electron. And from the reduction, we have 2 Cl- and 2 H2O. Before we call it done, let's look at the equation. So it looks like we have H2O appearing on both sides of the equation. So let's simplify that. And that's going to give us 1 H2O on the left-hand side. Same thing, we have H+ appearing on both sides. So let's simplify, and then we have 2 H+ on the right-hand side. and we also have 4 electrons on both sides of the equations, we're going to cancel them out, and that gives us no more electrons. If you have different number of electrons at this point, that means something went wrong somewhere. Chances are high that you forgot to multiply in step 3, so go back and check your work. Okay, so now let's rewrite our equation, and that gives us N2O plus H2O plus 2ClO minus, giving us 2NO2 minus plus 2H plus plus 2Cl minus. That is our balance equation in acidic condition. If acidic condition is what you're looking for, then you're pretty much done and you can stop right here. But like this question, if you're looking to balance the equation in basic condition, we have one more mini step to go, and that is to add OH minus on both sides of the equation for every H plus that you see. So from our acidic condition, we have 2H plus. So that means we're going to add 2OH minus on both sides like this. On the right hand side, that 2H plus and that 2OH minus is going to combine and it's going to give us 2H2O. Notice we have H2O appearing on both sides of the equation. We're going to simplify and that is going to give us H2O on the right hand side. And now we rewrite the equation and we get N2O plus 2ClO minus plus 2OH minus, giving us 2NO2 minus plus H2O plus 2Cl minus. That is our equation in basic condition. To recap, we went through these 4 steps in balancing redox equation in acidic and basic condition. When we add the electrons in step 3, we need to make sure that we add it on the right hand side for oxidation and to the left hand side for reduction. For acidic condition, there should be H plus in the equation, and for basic condition, we should have OH minus and no H plus in the equation. Just to be super safe, we should always double check our final work to see if the number of atoms and charges are equal on both sides of the balance equation. I hope the 4 steps in balancing redox equations were helpful. Do subscribe and thanks for watching.